And then Raimund von Hofmannsthal, well, he was very, very remarkable too, although he would have been the last person to say he was. He was the son of Hugo von Hofmannsthal, who was Austria, probably with Rilke, was Austria's greatest poet. And he wrote all the librettos for the Strauss operas. He wrote Rosenkavalier, he wrote Arabella, and that was really, I think, how he made a lot of his fame. And he wrote a play called Jedermann, which is still played every night during the Salzburg Festival in front of the cathedral. And anyway, he had a very, very, very high reputation as a poet and writer. And Raimund was his son. And when my mother went to act in this great play, The Miracle, which lasted for 10 years, Raimund was there for quite a lot of the time. And she was 30, he was 17. But he fell in love with her, as they all did. And she took him on as a sort of, I don't know, as a sort of cavaliere servente, you know, as a sort of a companion figure who would do the little jobs, and which he was delighted to do. And he was an absolute darling. And he, in the 1930s, then fell in love with my niece, Elizabeth Paget, and who was probably the most beautiful girl of her generation. I mean, she was an absolute knockout. And her parents were far from pleased. You know, they thought she was going to marry the Prince of Wales. And to have this Austrian, half-Jewish, bohemian figure was not quite what they'd expected or what they wanted. But in a very short time, he became their favorite son-in-law. He wooed Liz magnificently because they begged my father was at that time, we're talking about 1936 or early 37. My father was at that time First Lord of the Admiralty. And he had this yacht, the Enchantress, on which he was meant to go out and inspect the fleets, that sort of thing. And my parents were allowed to take their friends on it too, as long as they paid for them. There's no reason why they shouldn't bring them along. So my aunt, Liz's mother, said to my mother, look, do please take Liz on this Mediterranean cruise you're going to do, because it'll get her away from Raimund, and maybe she'll meet someone else, and you know, wouldn't that be nice? But of course, it wasn't as easy that, because every single port they stopped at, there was Raimund on the quayside with a huge armful of lilies. And he was very, very romantic and absolutely enchanting, spoke perfect English but with a strong Austrian accent all his life, and just had immense charm, humility. I never heard him say a nasty thing about anyone. He liked gentleness and beauty and elegance, but he wasn't a sort of prig about it at all. I mean, he was the lightest possible in the hand and full of jokes and laughter. And I think he was an enormous influence on me. We knew him very, very well. I mean, he was my parents, Raimund and Liz, were my parents' greatest friends. I mean, when they came to London for the weekend from France, on arrival, they'd go and have dinner with Raimund and Liz, you know, always. And at one moment, I stayed in their house when I was in the Navy for a bit in Connaught Square. And he was a great, great influence on me, merely because I think of his elegance, and I don't know, that he sort of radiated a wonderful sort of gentle charm. And you know, I mean, he loved Mozart and he loved poetry, and at the same time, you know, he was completely un-priggish. He was just enormous fun, but he hated anything to be ugly, you know. And I loved him very, very much, as we all did. We all did. He died about 20 years ago now. But his son, I still see his son is around in London, and I see him. He's a great friend.